She's Patricia. Like, Otis, why are you shooting at? You're gonna bring more of them on us.
Patricia. She's like,
shut up, Patricia. I know what I'm doing.
Hi, Patricia. I'm Frank.
What the hell's the... She sees the RV. She's like, what are they doing here?
We found a place for you to live. Well, they did.
And a couple.
I was just living there.
Everyone who's in this, it's like a clown car at this point. People just spilling out. And everyone's out now. The whole green, or what's left of the green family. And it was just like,
yeah, everyone, get back inside. I'm taking care of this.
And, Lacey's like, really, Otis? You're taking care of this? Look at this place. And Otis's like, shut up! You know, he's getting really aggravated right now.
All
right,
Otis, just calm down.
Don't tell me to calm down!
And he's just like...
Otis has a heart attack.
Roll charisma.
Yeah. Otis has a heart attack.
20.
So apparently the criminal is better than the criminal.
I just need Bye. To know how to roll. They're like the same thing, really.
And so,
they're like the same thing.
Two parallel stories, eight adventurers. Will they collide? Starring Connor.
I'm gonna just give you some food for it.
Danny.
Do it.
Devin.
You can go to 5 or 6 stores for just one.
Ryan. Nick. Ryan.
Build the wall.
Nathan.
Pain just means you're alive.
Brandon. This is The Walking Dead, Dungeons & Dragons, Season 4.
So Otis is just like...
Me asking him to calm down, actually calm down. Yeah.
He's hit the sweet spot.
What do you want?
Well, I ain't up, you're up, right? I don't know these people.
We want you to come back. Look. What Yosef and what Abrams did. We're trying to right that wrong. And look at this place. I don't know about you, but this place doesn't look like it has many more miles left in it. So it's just like...
Because the house is
you hear from, like, miles away, we have food.
And Otis is just like... well, it's pretty evident. Look at the fire, and of course you can see zombies sort of semi-approaching from the forest.
Some gunshots.
Yeah. He's just like...
Come on, Otis, it's time to go! Motherfucker.
You get a 1.
Ah, 4.
So he's like, I'm thinking! Shut up, asshole!
Take your time.
Fuck you. Take your time. He's like... And then Lacey's
rolls
like,
again.
She's like, Otis,
I ain't taking my time.
We need to go for the kids. And he's like,
think of the kids.
We sent one of the hell of the party to go tell a police officer and a criminal.
Yeah. And he's like, pack your bags, everyone. We're going. And so, you've convinced Otis to,
look at you go.
Do this. And he's like, so everyone, so you know, let's say a half hour or so passes. Everyone's got their bags packed and start loading into the
What's
RV.
What's the zombie situation?
They're probably at the fence now. It's a pretty big fence, yeah. It's still quite a ways away, probably 90 feet from the house.
Huge.
And then the house to the RV is another 90 feet. They're still a ways away, but... So,
and, well, just before you guys take off, well, actually, yeah, so Otis hops in the RV, and, well, your windshield,
yep.
Your windshield is just cold. Shrek'd.
Yep. Yeah. Just put Otis just, like, hang on one side. Time,
so there's a big hole in the windshield now, and Otis like, sorry about the windshield. It's real cold here, this drive, isn't it?
Do you have any sheets?
Sheets? Oh.
Put it behind us.
You got any bed sheets in the house?
Well,
yeah,
a tarp?
In the house, the big farmhouse. Well, you know, Otis isn't a thinker, that's for sure.
A tarp that we can duct tape to the front?
Oh, yeah. And probably some old duct tape or something. We could cover up this hole best we can.
Like every other person in the real
world. So, you know, maybe about 20 more minutes passes, and
they have all the beds packed in the home.
Yeah, they use, they take some thick blankets and just sort of slap it on the windshield and, like, thickly tape it on and stuff.
The front windshield?
Yeah.
No, I meant behind the guy driving, so the people behind the guy driving are warm.
Oh, well, Otis,
it'd be good for the guy driving to see the road.
Yeah.
Oh, well, it's like half. Yeah.
Oh, well,
the driver's side is all right.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, well then.
Yeah.
Exactly. We didn't know where the hole was. So
yeah.
One of you said, we still have a big sheet on it.
Really. Yeah. And now, just as the first zombie sort of touches the RV, Rick...
It blows up.
Yeah. Thanks for playing.
Roll credit. Yeah, roll credit.
And
he actually hit like the gas
tank.
Yeah. Oh
yeah. Like
GTA.
You don't license plate. They go.
It's
roll credits.
It's like a video game. Your vehicle has 1 HP left, but it's still in good condition.
Yeah.
It just takes that one bit of damage and just.
Yeah. So Rick begins to back it up, and so you guys start sort of heading back. Yeah. Back on the outside, after a meticulous search, you find a set of keys.
How many sets of keys?
One.
There's only, how many other guards were there?
Five.
Five other guards?
Yeah.
What do they all have on them?
Same sort of material, handcuffs.
Guns.
So two of the guards had pistols.
Okay.
Two Berettas.
This is an owl.
Yeah. Two Berettas with one mag each, 15 bullets per mag.
I already had the stats for bullets.
Yes, I have diplomacy.
Okay.
Bluff.
And so you find two of those.
And two magazines.
Yeah.
Each.
No, one magazine per pistol. And that's so two total. And you find five batons. Five sets of handcuffs.
Five batons.
Actually, four.
Four sets of handcuffs.
And then,
that's a lot of handcuffing.
Yeah. You have one set of keys. Yeah.
Do I find any handcuff keys?
They're on the set of keys.
Okay.
They are the set of keys.
Yeah.
And how is like a big set of keys?
It's like a ring, like a big ring of keys
like
with
I
a
know,
bunch of keys
like,
on it.
Okay, so
yeah.
Like, does it have three keys on it? Does it have 30 keys on it?
Let's say about 15 keys.
Okay.
Yeah, or so. A large ring of keys. Jingle, jangle, jingle.
Okay.
Yeah.
Zombies aren't going to hear that.
Yeah.
Shing, shing,
ching, ching, ching. Sir, there's someone in plate mail approaching us.
Yeah.
Ching, ching, ching.
Can you buy some keys?
Yeah.
Watch.
Don't buy us. We're fake.
That was
even.
And so, back in the prison. So, Paul and Mason. What were you guys doing?
Probably like making like hand muppets out of the flashlights.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Because I can't remember.
We were stabbing some zombies. Yeah,
that's
so.
It. So you,
you were knifey knifey.
You killed all the zombies at this point in Block A. And is there anything you'd like to do?
Each other.
Bloxy.
Okay. Five cell Bloxy.
Okay.
Let's not do that.
No?
Well, you know where cell Bloxy is. It's right up beside B and the door is shut. Or was shut. Last time you saw it.
Go kick it down?
Bloxy?
Yeah. The door was shut. Yeah.
So we're in the cafeteria and it's A.
BC.
ABC?
Yeah.
We can, like, draw a map or something.
Yeah, you guys should be drawing maps, yeah. Because, I have a map here, but...
Is that an empty piece of paper?
So you have the cafeteria, and, like, B is the middle, and then A is on the left-hand side, and then there's the garage beside A. Yeah. And then B...
Do you have a picture?
What?
Do you have a picture?
Picture? I can't. I can't show you it.
Okay, so it has all the lighting on it?
Yeah, I wrote all over this map, so it has spoilers on it.
What the fuck?
Okay. Yeah.
Let's see what you
want. I wrote a cafe.
And, and cell block C is beside B.
I don't know, I'm gonna play, if you could just, like, not maybe draw a map for me. Is this is how I'm doing the description. We can do it later.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm a visual person.
Yeah.
Okay, so what are we doing next?
Where A? I mean, so what connects to A?
A is a hallway.
A is just a hallway to
B. It's sort of a, and also there's like a second floor to cell block A, because the second row cells above. There's also like a sort of a platform bridge across the gap. Yeah.
So I guess we go down that hallway too. Back to B?
Yes. So you go back to B site and you notice something's just a slight different than last time. Cell block C's door has been opened.
Dun, dun, dun. Wanna see what's in that?
Spot check!
Yeah, let's spot check. 12 plus 3,
6,
15.
So, you're sort of distracted by just the craftsmanship of the door, the iron bars. You're like, huh, wait a second.
Shiny.
God damn.
You know, you being a scientist or something, you might be wondered, you might find some wonder in
the way the
something.
Rust is working.
Yeah.
Look at this chemical reaction.
But you realize there's something not right about what's going on here. And just as you grab the door to open it, you hear a gunshot go off on the inside.
Like in cell block C?
Yeah.
Coral.
Let's get a gun out, head up.
Diplomat. You go first.
Yeah.
Okay.
We need to build a wall.
Alright, so you enter cell block C. Yeah. You find all the cells, well, it's spotted. Some of the cells are locked, and then there's one cell in particular that's open.
Spot check. Who's in here?
17 plus 3.
17 plus 4.
So what you find is two naked people.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. They would have been Tyreese's daughter and the daughter's boyfriend are in here. And there's a lot of blood. And, he's just like... And you guys enter and Chris has a gun in his hand. He's just like... We were supposed to shoot a zero. And you see Julie, the daughter, has a bullet hole in her chest, and she's on the floor dead. Yeah, and she's like,
"What was the game here?"
She's like, "It's not what it looks like. It's not what we were gonna do it together. We're gonna do it together." Yeah,
and I tell him to drop the gun.
He drops it. Yeah.
Don't even need to roll.
Someone who's gonna shoot himself. Pretty quick.
Diaries.
He's just like,
Diaries gone.
Julie! Yeah. So what do you guys do now?
Put some clothes.
Yeah, it's just some naked dude and some naked woman in a...
Well, you tell him to leave, then you close the door, and then you have some fun. Necrophilia.
Sweet Jesus.
Necrophilia?
No, Nick.
That's their nick. Sorry, sorry. Time for your checkup. So, what do you guys do?
Exactly what he said. Ask what happened.
We were gonna do it together. End it all.
Does anybody else hear a gunshot in the prison?
You know, just as a meta comment like that occurs, you hear running behind you. It's Tyreese.
It's not only meta, it's a question.
Yeah, but you're not here, right?
Well, I feel like I might have heard a gunshot.
You're in the cafeteria now. You would have heard the gunshot.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
That's what I mean, like...
So, Tyreese and Alan and Donna are here. And, or no, yeah, those three show up, and Tyreese's like, what happened? He hasn't entered the cell yet.
Tyreese? Come now?
What? What happened?
I have no idea. I think they were going to do suicide together, but they're naked for some reason. Your children?
What? And he enters the cell. Oh, no! And his daughter, you know, dead on the floor. And then Chris is like, he's just like, you son of a bitch! You killed my daughter!
Who's he saying that to?
Chris.
Okay.
The boyfriend. He's just like,
don't you mean, like, don't you mean sister?
We're gonna do it together.
Yeah, are they siblings or...
boyfriend, girlfriend.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought there was a sibling.
Oh, you mean children? Weird. And I'm like, oh. But there's only... What?
Yeah, yeah, no. Only Tyreese is... Only Tyreese only has a daughter. Oh, and then Chris was the daughter's boyfriend. Okay. Yeah.
You said... Because whenever you said children, I'm like, isn't there only one child? Yeah, yeah. They're both siblings?
Child.
What? I mean, they're both youngish, right? You could call them children. Being a 42-year-old
I'm a 43-year-old man, you know. Rockets.
Yeah. And so... Tyreese is grip... He's white-knuckling his hammer, and he's just like, you wanted to? I'm gonna send you right there. And he looks back at you guys, he says, get out, now. Chris is like, wait, oh, please, please. And then he's just like, leave.
Wait, you can't just kill him.
And, well, just as you guys say that, He strikes Chris in the face. And, yeah, he strikes Chris in the face.
Take a couple swings.
Yeah, and Chris falls to the floor like, oh! You know, just sort of broke his jaw, right? Like, yeah, teeth fly out. And he's just like, he's like, and he's...
You understand that?
Okay, I'm gonna, like, pull my gun out and tell him to stop.
And so he looks at you with just, you can see the fury.
Should I roll for this?
You see the fury and the hatred.
Diplomacy.
And he's just like,
stop! 18 plus 4, I have like 4 from diplomacy, do I add anything else to it?
No, that'd be good, yeah. Okay. And so he's like, oh, you tell him to stop, and he's just like, he killed my daughter.
You can't really assume genders, like...
I know he might have a penis, but...
Fuck! This Apache helicopter killed my daughter!
This is
it's either me or him.
No, it's not how it works.
How long have you lived in this world?
He's gonna hit you.
Oh, I thought that was a 19 as well. 8 plus 4, 12.
So he's like...
No!
He breaks down in tears, and so Alan and Donna at this point have run off. They're gonna secure the cafeteria, keep their kids away from this scene, make sure no one else sees this.
The naked guy and his naked girlfriend.
And but you guys all witness the following event unfold.
But not all.
Well, and you see Julie start moving.
I say I'm on my way.
Yeah. Well, you run into Alan and Donna along the way, but we'll get to that in a moment. And you see Julie. Her eyes open up, and she sits up.
Is she like clearly a zombie?
And well,
she was dead, and now she's alive.
So. Tyreese is like, but she wasn't bit.
Wait, do we know anything about the cause?
I think we do.
I have my stuff.
I think we kind of know.
You have a hunch, but you've never seen it.
I have a better hunch.
You've never been able to prove a hunch before.
The hunch bunch?
Well,
I've never been told anything.
Okay.
Yeah. So. And so you see, he's like, but she wasn't bit.
I'm just going to say it doesn't matter, and then pull out my derringer. And shoot her.
Okay.
Okay. Rip.
Yep, this is not going to go well.
Six.
Pulled a six. Add.
Dex.
Plus 1. 7.
She's still prone.
Okay. Prone rules apply. Roll 2d6.
Why are your stats so high? Holy shit.
2.
3.
5.
So you deal 5 damage, and yeah, you put the barrel of the derringer to her head, and you pull the trigger, and, well...
How much damage does a 9mm Beretta do?
2d6.
Same.
Yeah. And, yeah, so you pull the trigger, and, well, take into account that Derringer is, like, a tiny, tiny little pocket pistol. Yeah,
but it's the caliber.
Yeah. And then, you know, Julie is splattered, and Tyreese is like... And he looks at you with just some extreme hatred. She's like, are they yet? And Chris is like,
I've heard much for gunshots.
And so, well, you haven't heard the second one yet. We're just, bear with me here. We're going back in time just a smidgen.
I can run faster than the speed of sound.
Yeah!
We're cutting back to the moment where Alan and Donna enter the cafeteria, and everyone's like, what happened? What's the gunshots? And maybe you are, whatever you ask. And Alan and Donna are like...
But whenever the first one goes, that's when I would have like started going.
Yeah, well, then you run into them on the hallway. And so, it's just like, suicide pack. Julie and Chris tried to kill themselves.
Okay,
you just run past them?
Like I'm like okay, keep good. Like I stop it. Like I stop. They tell me that, and then I go by.
They're like okay, and so they leave. And when you are approaching, you hear a second gunshot go off.
Okay.
Yeah. So you would enter this. You enter the scene, and you see. Well, you see Paul holding a barrel of a gun over Julie, and you see Mason standing by, Tyreese on his knees with a bloodied hammer, and Chris on the ground like. Yeah.
Wait, he hit Chris with a hammer?
Yeah.
Oh, fuck, I thought he punched him.
No, it was a hammer.
He said he holds his hand with a white knuckle. And
yeah. And Chris just like, or Tyreese is like, and he smashes down on Chris's head again.
Fuck.
And,
what happened to the diplomacy?
Looks like everybody hates Chris.
Yeah. Find a hole.
What's
crawl
your
in
strength,
it.
Nick?
Strength.
Just pass me
like
that.
A solid 10.
Yes.
10.
Shit. Five, 11.
Chris is like, I'm just smart. Barely.
Depends how this hit does.
I'm pretty sure it's just
gone. That first hit would have sent.
Chris to the fucking chair, man.
Get fucked, four eyes!
Oh, yeah, they're stumpy.
Shit. Oh, yeah, Tyreese
just
is
cheering them on. Yeah!
Oh, man.
My God. I didn't see that.
Shit,
you
got
back clapping like,
get
fucked, four eyes!
Alright, and so, yeah, he strikes Chris in the head again. He's just like, you know,
okay.
His nose is like snapped, and he's just like.
I'm gonna yell for someone to get Tyreese off Chris.
Who?
All together now!
And so, does anyone grab him?
Yeah.
Right, you grab strength check. Now,
like I said, all together now!
I wish I was fucking there.
16.
He beats you.
Okay.
And, you try to grab and he elbows you out of the way, and he smashes down on Chris's head again, dealing... Yeah. This is the strike, where he caves, a sort of, you hear this crack, thud, snap, just this awful sound, and you see this massive dent, sort of like, in Chris's skull, and he's just like, smash! And, you know, there's, you know,
yeah.
Yeah. And there's, you know, there's, you know, blood.
But this isn't
necessarily
us.
Yeah, Tyreese is just...
No, I mean your group is the good guys.
And so he's like...
Yeah.
You don't know the comparison.
Yeah. And Chris is
watch
no
the
longer
other
moving at this point after that thunderous smash.
Oh, if you want to come back. Use thunder smite.
Yeah.
Use thunder... Smash!
Thunder. Use Thunderbolt.
And so, at this point...
I don't think he's gonna stop.
Yeah, no one's grabbing him, so...
Well, after I saw the heck, I'm like, I'm not gonna grab him, because I'm like, if he is alive, he's just gonna put him out of his misery.
Yeah.
I'm not bringing him back
and,
from that.
And Tyreese is like,
you
know, an agonizing scream, and then he just... goes ham on Chris's head.
He goes green eggs and ham.
You know, maybe, so...
Whenever he starts calming down, I'll grab him.
Yeah, and after a couple, maybe a minute at most, of just constant thrashing, there's nothing much left of Chris. And, so you guys are, unless you guys left, you guys witnessed this entire event unfold, and, Chris is no longer recognizable. Yeah.
Oh, God.
And so... He drops the hammer, and it's just, you know, it's smattered with, you know, blood and gore. And, so he's just like...
The mic has been dropped.
I'm gonna slowly go and grab the hammer.
Yeah.
Not for you.
Let's go from this out.
You're grounded. No hammer.
We lock it in.
Yeah.
No!
So, who suggests that? And Tyreese just looks at you, he's like, I'm good. I'm good.
No, you fucking
idiot. So,
you ain't nothing but
what do you do? He says he's good. And obviously 30 seconds ago he was not good.
Yeah.
I'm fine, I swear.
Everybody gets one.
whenever they kill family, it's a flea.
It's two less mouths to feed. Okay.
So,
the shit fridge doesn't fill up as fast.
What's your strength?
11.
Fuck. Why are we all so weak?
We're talkers, not fighters.
talkers, not fighters.
I have 18 wisdom.
I have 18 con.
Yeah.
I
have 14 con.
I'm a healthy fighter.
I'm a wise person. I'm not. It's your intelligence.
Apparently, I'm also.
And well, obviously, you guys want to lock eyes.
Okay. Someone else help me. I'm taking him and throwing him into the cell that's open.
And Tyreese just says, "No need. I'm gonna get rid of the bodies, and then I'll do what you want."
No, we can get rid of the bodies. Get in a damn cell.
He looks. He opens his eyes.
Just say, I'm not gonna stop this.
This is my daughter. And this asshole.
To my character, he had the right to do it.
Killed my daughter.
Yes, I realize. I was here for that.
Aye.
You need to get a damn cell so you don't do shit like that anymore.
Like I said, if Tyreese goes to punch him.
Oh my god!
Diplomat. So how hard?
What did he roll? What did he roll?
How hard does he? He rolled a one. How hard does he punch him?
Actually, yeah, he socks you right in the face.
How much health do you have?
10.
Dealing. 6 damage.
With a fucking punch?
Yeah.
Dude, how strong is this guy?
My best punch does 11.
What did you roll to
hit? He
rolled. My worst does 5.
11 plus.
My worst is 6.
Plus 3. And the con. The AC at most is 12.
You're
so
at 4
plus
health.
Plus 3
health.
Plus another 1.
Holy
so.
Shit.
Yeah, he. I mean, I would assume.
What's
he.
What's your dex?
Plus
1.
How does
12.
1 get to 12 AC?
Winter coat. Yeah. Since you have a jumpsuit on, it's 11. Yeah. Just like a thin layer.
We also get dex too when we do it.
Yes. Yeah. Well, no, I haven't been applying the dex.
Do any of you even have dex?
I should, but I haven't.
You can't move it or a punch.
At this point, it's like, whatever.
And so, yeah, you take a haymaker of a sucker punch to the face.
You just took one hell of a hit.
6.
Yeah. I'm like 10 HP using.
He's at 4 now.
I'm at 4 health. He punches me again and I fucking die. So someone give me a goddamn hand here.
Or just stop talking.
Yeah, I'll give you my hand.
Oh, get wrecked.
Yeah, so at this point, you're just saying sorry.
You know, imagine this.
Your best chance is to say sorry.
I'm assuming you're imagining this as just slight payback for the hand incident. Just
I
a
mean,
little bit. It's a little bittersweet, a little bit.
Sweet
you obviously
care.
You wouldn't let Tyreese go too far,
no.
Right? But it's just like, one punch.
It was satisfying to see just the.
So, what
physical extent did the punch do?
Crooked nose, you've got a crooked nose and like there's a bit of blood dripping down your face.
You almost fucking died.
And so you flew against the wall. So how do you react to that? And Tyreese just looks.
I think
at
that point it's sorry.
I'm getting rid of my daughter. I will take care of it. And then, and only then, will I cooperate.
Reason he doesn't want me to help get rid of the body.
Okay, see, fine, get rid of the fucking bodies.
Alright, he wouldn't like my hacksaw moments.
Yeah.
Get rid of bodies.
And so, so he's gonna take care of that, and we'll be back after the break. I got
two. Mm.
Yeah, I guess. Hey. I'm perfect on simple weapons, too.
That gives you +2+2.
+2+3. Well, that's plus there. Different weapons proficiency gives you +2?
What's
your
simple weapon proficiency gives you +2?
Simple weapons proficiency just eliminates the negative modifier. But everyone starts with that, so.
Okay. What do you mean? What negative modifier?
Well, if you didn't have that, you would have a -4 on.
To hit someone with a bat?
Yeah. But since everyone is born with that innate ability, it just gets rid of that modifier. But you could choose to get rid of it.
Because, like, with simple weapons, whenever it comes to, like,
well, in D20 Modern, that's how it works.
Really?
Yeah. Damn. I'll double check the rules, but in 5th edition, of course, in 5th edition,
gets
Wizards
plus
of the Coast,
to swing
D&D,
with a bat. Gets
the
weapon's
proficiency
gives
you +2.
Like this.
Yeah. But in this, no, it takes away.
What's the damage of just like a club?
1d6.
1d6, yeah.
That's the same as my punch.
Yep. But of course, the club wouldn't get the modifiers your fist does.
Yeah, well, my fist gets +1 to hit.
Yeah.
And instead becomes a 1d6 instead of a 1d4.
So. And we're back. So, yes. So, you guys have decided to let Tyreese. Or, well, maybe decided is too keen of a word to use. But you've let Tyreese take care of his daughter and the other one. Yeah. The victim of a crime, as it were. So, what do you guys do now?
Fight the boys.
I think I have a nose job to do.
Yes, please.
Oh, yes, yes.
And don't roll a 1, please.
Well, that's the only chance of me not being able to do it.
Would Tyreese have, like, a permanent...
And it's not like I'm doing anything on an eyeball or something.
Yeah, you try to fix my nose and accidentally kick me in the nuts.
Why don't you just get, like, some botulism in there, too?
Botulism, yeah.
You accidentally inject me with a syringe full of E. coli.
Ebola.
Yep.
You catch Ebola from a nose job. All right, and so if you want to roll to fix his nose there.
All better.
Will this heal?
Medical check.
So I'm guessing we're going to go back to the cafeteria. You know, get taken back to the cafeteria.
Yeah.
Down.
I'm assuming you guys aren't staying in this blood fest.
Yeah, I'm going to lay him down on a table. I'm going to get a couple people like, you want to hold his arms? Yes.
What are you doing?
I'm going to set your nose. I'm gonna take your broken nose and I'm gonna go like that to it.
Doctor! Doctor! Ah, you're bloody!
And
I'm Dr.
Nose! Like, go have him like a piece of cloth or something, like, bite on that.
I'll just give my dick.
Gives you a cloth to bite on, do you?
Sure. Hopefully it's plain.
Well.
I just wiped my ass with it.
Clean it up.
I took a shit outside. Whatever.
It's probably wherever it should be.
Seven.
I thought that was a
fucking
one.
So I got a 20.
Yeah.
Cool.
A 20, that's mental. That's mental.
And you think
luck
is broken.
It's like, it's almost like an arse. Just, it hurts. It hurts, mind you. But he successfully sets your nose.
Okay,
and
so
the,
my back up at 10 health.
Does he heal?
Roll a d4.
Cool.
Yeah.
Oh, so maximum 8.
2. +13.
Is that technically how it works?
I would just like.
No.
Think so.
Okay.
Whatever it is.
Like, so, I'm pretty sure there's not healing in this game.
Okay, yeah.
Unless it's like,
besides, like a med kit or something. Yeah.
Well, like.
Because we do,
like,
do
the
health.
The med kit's kind of like. I stop the bleeding, but he still lost that blood.
True. Yeah, since there is no magic. So you gain 2 health, though, from that. Yeah.
Up to 6, guys. Don't kill me.
And, the thing is, though, whenever I fix it, though, I have to, like, keep it set.
If I punch
so right
you,
now,
one, you die.
So just so you know for your looks right now, you actually have, like, 2 pads on the side of your nose, and then you have a piece of cloth running around your head just to try and keep it in place. So that's your new look.
Yeah.
Well, charisma -2.
Because, like, would like cast it, but I don't have casting things. So,
Just as, you know, you hear inside the cafeteria, Evan sort of looks over.
And they obviously see, like,
yeah,
2 people holding him down.
Yeah, and you setting his face.
Just like.
And, So, you know, a couple people ask, like, what happened to Tyreese? Where's everyone else?
I'm busy. They're talking to him.
So, a couple people ask you in the room, like Carol and stuff.
He's busy dealing with the dead bodies.
Oh. And Alan's like, yeah, that's what I meant. He's like, sorry, not good at explaining. And so, you know, there's a brief somber moment of,
None of them question why he said bodies and not body.
Because the 2 people only noticed the one body.
Oh, yeah,
body
no,
one.
They know. They sort of know now what Alan was trying to mean. And so just as this occurs, you see the cafeteria door open, and Rick and Frank enter.
The zombies.
Also with them is, open up the list here.
We're carrying
the family.
Shit,
the you guys, well, to you, they're new people. To you 3, they're new. But to everyone else in the group, they've seen these people before. They've lived with these people for a little small bit of time. And you see 2 little kids.
You guys have a nasally voice now.
God damn, I want to scream at him, but if he punches me, I die.
The thing is, though, you have to talk like this, though, because your nose, you can't really talk.
God damn it!
So, your diplomacy is not really helping you right now.
And so, you see a family enter the prison with all their bags and stuff.
As
and
they walk
like,
in, I look at them and say, mi casa es su casa.
And they're like, Otis is like, well, you don't know his name, but she's like, wow.
What a
bit of a shithole, but it's better than our shithole.
Wow. What
true.
A piece of shit.
It is better than your shithole.
And you see the green family
by a long
finds
shot.
Maggie, and they sort of a reunite. Aww. And they're all like, and the kids like, Maggie! And like, kids. And I mean, you know, she's got a box of Kleenex beside her, right? Because her relations just got shot in the back. And
literally.
Died today. Or yesterday.
So would they pass the body on the way in?
No.
Okay.
Glenn's body, well.
Barrier.
Technically, Glenn's body's still chilling out in the snow.
That's what I mean. Like, yeah.
They would have driven
Glenn.
Past. Well, they wouldn't have walked by. They
okay.
would have driven it.
I didn't know if
they just
one.
Left
so
him in
I
the
don't
snow.
Think they would have noticed. But,
just a kid looks out the
yeah.
window. Just Glenn.
Yeah. And, yeah, so there's all these new people in the prison. What do you guys want to do?
I'm going to go talk to them.
I'm going to just slip by. Right.
And
I'm going to just go explore.
Yeah, and Rick...
And whenever you look around, like, you see some bandages on someone's...
Yeah.
I fucking glare at him.
I just chuckle at him.
I glare angrily at him.
And Rick's like, what happened?
I'm gonna go to him.
To
like,
me?
Yeah.
Why to me?
For the fucking keys.
What keys? What are you talking about?
You know what you're... You know, Frank. Where's Tyreese? We're supposed to give
I'm
him a
master
key.
I'm going to talk to him.
Yeah, but Tyreese is the one in charge. Where is he?
He's out.
He's not asking me, I'm going to talk
to him. He's out dealing with bodies.
Well, you said you went off.
He's
leaving.
Who died?
His kid and her boyfriend.
Shit.
He did a suicide pact ritual.
Suicide. Fuck.
So do you, like, catch me as I'm going out the door?
Well, to be fair then, Chris didn't commit suicide.
He's
not beaten
going, like,
to death by Tyreese.
Nah, I'm going,
jeez.
I'm leaving
that's
the cafeteria
a problem.
Immediately.
And then punch me in the face, and I'm like, I'm almost dead.
I'm just gonna keep a food.
Yeah. Well, try to spare those details from the new people, okay? From as long as possible. And, so, yes, Vance, you approached Frank and asked for the key.
I immediately was leaving as, like, I'm walking just past everybody and going out of the cafeteria the other way.
Okay.
So it's up to him if he's still
Oh, so you're just wandering through the prison by yourself?
I'm